You ever have an off day? You ever have one of those days where you wake up and stub your toe and then you walk into the kitchen and get a glass of water and you drop your cup and then you try and make some breakfast and you burn it? You ever have one of those? I am having that day today times a billion. Over the last week, actually, I've been having that kind of week. Yeah, it's been a week for me, guys. Welcome back to another episode on the Single Player World. How's it going today? I hope you're having a super good day. I'm actually still having a pretty good day, although I'm having one of those days. Because that's all you can do, really. You know what I'm saying? Like, when you're having a day like that, you gotta make the best of it. So I'm back again, and we're playing on the world. We're doing some Minecraft today. So pour yourself a hot, tasty freaking beverage. Let's get started here. It's been some time. It's been some days. I've been busy. IRL and everything. I had to go log in there for a little bit. So I wasn't able to record, which means I got some progress done. I got a couple conceptual things figured out, and I am pretty excited to start the episode off here today. So we're just AFKing at the wood farm, getting some trees to work on a project. But first, I just wanted to tell you guys about some of the ridiculousness that's happened to me over the last week, okay? Just sit back. I know this is kind of probably a little bit loud for you, but hopefully it's not too crazy. But anyway, there's just been a couple things that have happened. I just wanted to give you guys a chronological order of what just happened over the last 2 days. So, just all specifically to do with Minecraft and recording and stuff. 2 days ago, I recorded an episode. It was a very good episode. I have talked about a lot of things. We had another real talk, and I realized that, you know what? I don't want to release another Real Talk video. Like, even though it was a really good video, it's like I wanted to give you guys some content because I had a sneaky suspicion that if I did a couple of those in a row, you guys might get sick of it. And so I decided to scrap the video. And so I was like, you know what? We're having a day without an upload. It's not too big of a deal. I do that every once in a while. Like, once or twice a week, I'll have a day where I don't upload anything, or maybe like 3 times a week or something like that. I'm not keeping too much of a schedule, I guess is my point. So it wasn't too big of a deal. Anyway, the next day comes around, and I was not able to record. And so that's 2 days that are, bam, 2 days without recording. So the third day comes around, and I start to record, and I'm halfway done with the episode, and bam, I gotta get distracted and stuff. So I also had to go and do stuff. So in between recording half the episode and then going and doing stuff, and I updated some games, and I downloaded a new game, and I had to delete some footage to make room, I deleted the first half of my episode. So that's 3 days down the drain. I'm so professional, guys. Don't you even worry about it. I'll figure it out. I get it. Anyway, yesterday, I think, is now what we're up to. I recorded an entire episode. I start to finish, 32-minute long episode. It was a good one. We did some stuff. We built a redstone project. We built an interesting other thing. We talked about a lot of stuff. But, you know, I was watching it back, and I just was bummed out the whole time. I was just bummed out. I was in a bad mood. And so instead of releasing a video for you guys of me in a bad mood, doing some halfway decent projects, having an okay time, I figured, you know what, let's scrap the heck out of that, and let's freaking come back when we're 100% Huxmeister. So that's what I did. I got a big freaking hot, tasty freaking whole dang freaking French press full of coffee, a whole bunch of redstone in a chest somewhere. And we are going to have a really good day today. We're going to get back to it. We're going to have a freaking normal day. Yeah, and I just wanted to let you guys know. I know I've been talking for a really long time, so we're going to get right back into the episode. I just wanted to explain it to you guys a little bit that I've been having a hard time the last few days, so I apologize. I have been trying every once in a while. You just run into one of those moments where you're just having a bad day or whatever. So, like always, this is a motto I live by. I'm going to leave you guys with before we break it. It'll be a half a second for you, but for me, it'll be a while. I just wanted to leave you guys with the thought that everybody has bad days. It's a human thing to have a bad day. It's how you deal with the bad day is what matters. And so if you are having a bad day, do everything you can to change your mood and to flip it around and do something about it. And that's just my advice to you guys, okay? So it's not about if you have a bad day or not. It's about how you deal with it. Anyway, that's it for the rant, for the talk. Let's get back to the freaking video. Start working on some projects today. So I will BRB. I don't know what it is, but apparently, like, my neighborhood, there's like three or four new houses going up. And so the last couple of days have just been like bang, 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 bang. So I apologize if there's some background sound effects. It's out of my control. So anyway, check this out. I've been working on Nether Hub. I've been working on a track selector system. Whoops. For the Nether Hub. Whoops. And I am super excited about it. So. Okay, not quite perfect yet, as you can see. it's just because I messed up there and I was being stupid. We'll fix that problem eventually. Can we please? Can we please? Can we please? Thank you. So anyway, I've been working on the Nether Hub, and I figured, you know what that every Nether Hub needs? You need a fancy track selector. So I was watching Ethos Labs LP the other day. And he was showing how you could make a cool little menu system, is how he was describing it. So I took that idea and ran with it immediately before he finished his episode off. before he finished the concept off, because he finished his episode. But he showed this in his episode. He showed you could make passwords that pick what words. You can make passwords that select a track for you. So that's what I've done here. Before I show you the redstone, I'll show you in action first. So what you do is you grab one of these, you go bam, and you put it back. Okay? So you saw that? So you dropped it out of the chest and it went into that hopper right below us. And there's a delay, and that's something that we'll fix eventually. This is just temporary. So you can see that we went onto this first rail. Everything is reset. And then when you're coming back, you go down the reset line up to here. I need to add some more powered rails too, and you get reset. So now we can choose the villager trading hub, for example. We could also do it like that and drop it out, however it works, but whatever you do, you just gotta make it into that hopper. I think that doing the first method's probably a little faster, but the delay gives you a lot of time to mess with that. You can see everything resets, everything's good. Then we go back on the line, and bada bing, bada boom. We got a track selector. Super cool. And the coolest thing about this is you could have like a double chest full of passwords and different lines and stuff. You could extend this out as long as you want, and you could have 1,000 freaking minecart tracks all the way down. And you could c select between each one of them by just dropping a password down, and it'll just depend. that'll just increase the time that it takes, obviously, because the item has to pass through the item filters, and that's how we were doing this. So check the redstone out. It's pretty simple, guys. It's pretty cool. I just randomly came up with this. Like, I saw Etho's idea, and literally the only thing that he showed was he literally said, if you haven't watched the episode, go and watch it. It's a really good one. He literally just said, like, hey, put some passwords in here, have it drop into a hopper, have that hopper select tracks. And I was like, you know what, I'm gonna do that right now. And I did it right now, and it was amazing. So yeah, just full credit to the idea, but obviously I came up with this all on my own. So it works how you could probably guess that we've got an item filter in here, or three actually. So we got a bam, a bam, a bam, and so each one of those obviously are named and everything. So what's happening here is when the signal is increased, so when one more item goes into there, it goes bam, and it activates the whole thing, and item filter is a thing. But it also activates that monostable circuit pulse. You see that with the one tick, which will quasi-connectivity power the piston, drop down the cauldron, and because it's just a single tick, it'll leave the cauldron behind. So it's a monostable into a T flip-flop, into the signal here from the comparator, because there's water inside the cauldron, obviously. And then that signal splits and it goes up. It'll switch the track. It'll also power the player rail, right, from up here. So it'll make the minecart go. And then after all of those things, after it switched the track, after it's pushed you down the track, then the reset line comes around. It monostable pulses, this time with a full delay. So what this prevents it from doing is turning into a clock. And it also allows all of these cauldrons to be picked up and none of the cauldrons to be left behind, because it's not a one tick monostable, it's a four tick. And so it acts the opposite. So it'll reset this whole line here. You can see that it'll pick up whatever cauldron has been left down there on the bottom. Oh my gosh, that was kind of complicated to explain. But anyway, I think that that's a pretty good explanation. Obviously, it's just ran by like this item filter hopper trail line, which sucks, and it makes it a really, really long process. And so if you got any ideas about how to quicken this up, I would be grateful for it. I got some ideas of my own, but maybe somebody's got some super sneaky smart method that I could implement here. I went for the manual system where you just every once in a while you're going to have to go and pick out the passwords and put them back in a chest. But I was almost thinking it would be pretty simple to do like a little minecart that like picks up the password and brings it back and puts it back in the chest. But, you know, I could just do like a whole freaking three stacks of each one, and we won't really have to worry about it very often. Anyway, yeah, I thought that was pretty cool. Once again, this is conceptual. There's some things that are going to change. I just had to show you guys this because I thought it was such a cool little redstone contraption. Yeah, and I apologize for not doing it on camera, but I think it's pretty much see it right there. You could probably copy it yourself if you wanted to. I might do a tutorial once I get it a little more polished. But yeah, that's it for, I guess, what I've been doing. Oh yeah, and the nether hub. Obviously, I can't believe I forgot. Ba-ba-ba-bum. Check it out. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. So, my gosh, it's just been such a crazy week. I had this entire sequence, whole big long montage of me doing all of this, but like I said, I accidentally deleted some footage, and so I lost it, unfortunately. But it's pretty straightforward. All you gotta know is the most frustrating thing that I've ever done in my entire life. I fell 1,000 times, I died twice, I killed 100 ghasts, and it was a process that's not even done yet. So, you know what? Let's pop down there actually. Kind of give you a better idea. Ooh, yeah, we got enough. I was looking at my elytra because we're almost out. I want to be careful that I don't run out of elytra over the lava or something stupid. Oh, because I don't have ender pearls or lava potions. Speaking of which, I'm gonna go back over here. Oh my god, I apologize. Oh, emergency mute. Did you just break my glass? I hate you. I hate you. Okay, so this is what I'm talking about. Every single time I was trying to work on this, we'd get a couple gas down here, and I don't know what it is, guys. I don't know why the spawn rates are so amazing, but I literally want to put a freaking gas farm right here because it's so good. It's so crazy the amount of gas that I've had to kill here. It's unreal. So, anyway, I just wanted to show you. I just wanted to fly really quick. You could probably see that. I just wanted to show you that wasn't the bottom, obviously, of the Nether, and so we're gonna keep working on it. But it's gonna take me some time. I'm gonna have to do some deep breath exercises before I work on it some more because it's so frustrating. But anyway, yeah, it's a thing. It is coming together. This is gonna be one of those projects. It's gonna be like multiple episodes in a couple weeks or something. I'll have something to show you. But for now, we're just gonna kind of chip away at it. Talking about kind of bigger c concepts here, we're gonna totally take all this out so it goes all the way down to the lava lake level. I'm gonna kind of carve away the edges here so we have a bigger field of view. And then I'm thinking about block choices, palette choices. Like, what do we do with these outside bits? There's some really cool stuff that we get to build. Really cool stuff that we get to do here, like a big auto smeltery thing, which I'm going to put back in a different way, which I'm super excited about. That'll probably be next episode. Yeah, and some big industrial pipes and stuff, like lava flowing out of it. Oh man, this is going to be cool. But anyway, let's get on with it. There's two projects that I want to do today, and so let's go look at the first one. Hopefully, we'll be able to freaking show you what I'm talking about and get it done with before the episode's over, or at least get it started. My gosh. There's just too much stuff to do today. I swear, like every single episode, if you guys could see a map of my brain, that's an amazing idea. Hold on a minute. I present to you the giant wall of ideas. So, I just had this idea real quick. You know what? Every episode, I try and explain to you guys, like, I have 1,000 things on my head, brain. I've got 1,000,000 projects to do. Like, sit back and relax, and let's pick one of the endless freaking things to do in this game. I am not joking, guys. When I say that, I'm really not joking. Like, right now, today, what I want to do is about 50 different things, but I've condensed it down into a wall of m the most important projects out of all of the things that I want to get to in my episodes over the next couple weeks. And so here it is. Here's an insight into my brain. I don't know why I wanted to do this so bad just now, but I figured I would give you guys a little sneak peek as to what I'm thinking about. So let's talk about each one individually, really quick. Nether tunnels are really obvious. I don't want to build a nether hub that has messed up tunnels and stuff like this. This is unacceptable. So, unacceptable. Oh man, I've been doing that a lot lately, inventing Dr. Seuss words. So, obviously, I want to polish up every single tunnel entrance in here. So that's what I mean by nether tunnels. Auto smeltery is replace the smeltery that I broke, and then, you know, finish this up. Like, this is all broken, and this is all broken, so we gotta fix those things, get the smeltery back online, which will help us do pretty much everything else. So that's like a huge priority. That's probably next episode. Chicken Shack, which is this episode, which I'm really excited about, so I'll save that one for later. Finish the mob farm is because, obviously, it is not done. I really need to do that, because that's a... It's just one of those things I'm having a really hard time figuring out how I want to finish it off. Same with the iron farms. I don't really have a reason to do 4 more iron farms, so it's hard for me to motivate and do that when I've got so many other things to work on. So one of these days we will finish and do 8 total iron farms over there, which will be amazing. A leaf farm, which kind of fits into this one too. So these two kind of go together. We got to work on the Mesa base place because I got a million freaking, like... Oh my god, it's ideaception, I swear. In this idea, there's about a million other ideas. So I kind of just made that all in one to kind of condense it. But the leaf farm is a huge part of that. We need to find a way to AFK for leaf blocks. I'm not sure how I'm going to do it, but that's essential. A melon farm is kind of just for fun thing, but I realized that I need an emerald supply. And we don't have anything right now that's like really producing that we can trade with. So I want to get a melon farm that's somewhere... totally off on its own, so we don't have to worry about lag. And I want to go way too overboard and like almost crash the game with the amount of melons that I'm producing. So that'll be a really fun episode. Super excited about that. That's something I want to do. Nether hub decor, obviously, that's kind of the same with the nether tunnels, but I want to decorate under here, and that's going to be a huge project as well. Moving right along, the Snowy Kingdom. This is a project that I've had in my mind for a couple years now, and I want to do it. And I figured that this would be a perfect place to do that because I've got a really cool spot laid out. So one of these days, we're going to start on that project. I'm very excited. It'll be similar to here, but we're going to do the opposite. So we made a custom biome in the desert. We're going to make a custom biome in the tundra. Very, very excited about that. Witch farm? I need to redesign my witch farm. It's broken. And there's another witch farm right next door, so I might build a second witch farm. So that'll be a really cool episode as well. I'll be able to do a whole witch farm and stuff. Oh my god, this is crazy. The wither farm is something that I need to finish as well. I've shown you barely a little tiny bit of it, but that is a gigantic freaking project. So that's just another one of those things that in a few weeks, I might have, oh my gosh, some progress on it for you guys. But anyway, mining operation. So I don't have a mine. I don't have a place to mine. I want to set up an array, like a giant array, like 4 or 5 beacons long by 4 or 5 beacons wide. That's all haste 2. And it's a giant area of haste 2, and you can just mine the heck out of it. There's minecart systems and item elevators and storage arrays and all kinds of cool stuff. So that's an episode in itself. And I want to do that to get lapis, basically, only. Is like to get lapis and redstone and stuff. And coal, I guess. Yeah. Jungle biome, which fits into the library. So I want to do a library because I have a million enchanted books and levels, and so I want to put that somewhere cool. And I figured the jungle biome would be a cool place to put that, which is right next to the Mesa base place. So I want to do a custom biome there as well. And then a library on top of it. So, once again, this is like a million ideas compressed into a small collection of ideas to kind of give you just a picture, a window into how I plan things out, into what I want to do in the series in the next few weeks, months, a year. You know what I'm saying? So it's not going to take me that long. I want to bang these things out. I really want to do all these projects. Oh man, and it's just it's picking between each one of them every day. Excuse me. It's like looking at the mental map in my head and like, what is the most important or what's the most necessary or what's going to be the most fun? So looking at this now, you know, obviously there's a couple things I could choose from, but I'm going to go for the chicken shack. And the only reason is because mentally I've wanted to do this for years. I'm not even joking. For years I've wanted to do this. And I think the best way to get over there would be to go to the charge creeper farm. Okay, so you can see we have a lot of dirt. Not as much grass because I'm clearing it out with the same method we used to do the other passive mob farm. If you're curious, go back and watch the episodes. I'm not going to explain it. It's because it's real simple. You just use the water to kill the grass. All right. So anyway, let's take a freaking peep at this. I zoomed in because I'm amazing. So We're on this little island, you can see, covered in water. Everything's groovy. And all around it, there is no grass. You see the mesa down there is a mesa. There's no grass, so it might as well be water. Pretty much render distance in every direction is just more water. It's awesome. It's so, so cool. So let me explain. You know, I already built a passive mod farm. You guys are probably like, are you gonna build another passive mod farm? Like, geez, what are you doing with your life? Well, this is gonna be a very special, very unique mob farm. Check out the rates, by the way. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. I was really surprised I was able to find another place to build a passive mob farm on console edition. I thought it was gonna be way harder to find a spot like this, but it's actually quite easy. I found it really quickly. It's kind of surprising, and only like a map away from spawn as well. All right, so my point is it looks like if you guys are going to try and do a passive mob farm, you don't have to get as incredibly lucky as I thought I was getting lucky. It looks like most worlds will have a spot like this for you to find. Anyway, can I please just stop moving? So, oh my god, guys, I've tried to explain this before. I'm going to try and explain this again. What is going to happen here? And like I said, I've had this idea for years. Not even joking you. Literally years I've had this idea, and we're going to make it happen. Here in the world, in the series, I am so freaking excited. So, the thing about eating food in this game is you gotta kill animals if you wanna eat meat. Now, of course, you could be a vegetarian, this perfectly acceptable methodology, but if you don't have a super crazy overpowered gold farm like I do, then you probably won't be able to make golden carrots. So basically, all the vegetables are gonna be next to worthless because stuff like meat is just infinitely better for your saturation values and stuff. So you're constantly going to be having to eat if you do decide to be a vegetarian. So in the interest of humane farming and food industry hot word hype, I will create here on this island a free-range organic chicken farm. That's right. We're not going to have any compact glass box, squeeze them all into one little block, and kill them with lava in some terrible, horrible way. It makes me sick. It makes me sick you guys would do that to your sweet little chickens. You know, I actually have chickens in real life, and they are the sweetest little animal. Like, they're crazy, and they'll bite you. But at the same time, my gosh, they're the cutest, sweetest little birds. So I just can't deal with the fact that we're killing chickens by the metric buttload at the passive mob farm. So to make up for it, we're gonna have a free-range, organic, humane, family-friendly chicken shack out here on a tropical island. So that's the plan. How am I gonna do that, you might ask? Well, I'm glad you asked, Timmy. So we're gonna use a couple mechanics that I've never seen anybody do this. I've never heard about this being done. I've never heard anybody talk about this. I've never seen this built before, and I'm so freaking excited about it. I just don't even know why I haven't seen it before. It's such a great idea. So we're gonna have chickens in one area. They're gonna be free range. It's probably gonna be over here. I'm gonna fence it off and everything so they're contained in one little area. But as they lay eggs, those eggs are gonna be collected by a minecart right underneath the ground. And then that minecart is gonna take the eggs over to here, over to the other side of the island, where there's gonna be a secondary pen, a secondary free range pen, where it's gonna hatch the eggs with dispensers, right? And so this is all going to be 100% automatic, okay? Following me? So the chickens are going to be free roaming. They're not going to be trapped in a box. The eggs are going to be collected by a minecart hopper. The hopper is going to dispense them, or it's going to put them into a dispenser. The dispenser is going to activate the eggs from underground. It's going to hatch chickens. They'll automatically be generated over here in this little area. And that's because the passive mob cap is not full, right? It'll be able to do that infinitely here on the console edition. And then after that, what we'll probably do is have an automatic killing mechanism. And I want to make sure that we come up with the quickest method of killing possible to maintain absolute humanity, humane and humanities with death killings of chickens. So that's the goal. I am so freaking excited. Like I was talking about, I've had this idea for years, and I just can't wait to try and figure it out. So like always, with the Redstone, we're going to run into a whole bunch of issues, I know. We're going to run into problems and puzzles and different things. So hopefully we'll be able to figure it out. I'm going to quit talking. I guess I'm going to do a little bit more work. This episode, I'm not going to have too much progress just because I've done a lot, so it's a lot of updates. I haven't been around for a few days, so I hope you can understand. I'm going to get going right away after this one on the next one, and so I'll have some progress for you guys, and it'll be out pretty soon. So anyway, like I said, I've done enough talking. I think that was the last of the grass. And like, as you can see, I don't really need to do any perimeter action. I don't need to clear any other grass away. I think we did it. So one other quick little thing to think about. I'm not sure if I want to keep this kind of texture and stuff, like just the dirt and the sand. I kind of want to go for one or the other, like have it all be just chocolatey brown dirt or have it all be sand. That was one idea. Or I could bring over some like green clay and kind of pretend like there's grass on this island, which is also a cool idea. So I'm going to mess around with it. But like I said, I'm going to do some work. I'm going to try and do something to show you. And I will be our... And we're back. So... I've been doing some work, just a little bit of work, and I've come up with some cool ideas. I got some plans, but you know what? I think I'm going to have to call it here for today. I know I didn't get very much done today. Like I said, I hope you guys can understand a little bit more of like an updatey thing since I have spent a lot of time away from the game over the last week. And yeah, I just really don't have enough time to record. So a lot of the big projects and stuff that I've been trying to do lately and that you've seen before on this channel have been really hard because I just don't have the playtime that I have in the past. So I'm going to try and do my best. Like I said, I'm going to get going on another episode here pretty quickly and try and kind of get more work done on this project. But I would like you guys to do me a solid, all right? Everybody do me a favor here, other than the normal hanging out and hitting buttons and viewing the videos and being super awesome like you do. I would like, never done this before, but I want to do this here today. I would like some inspiration. That's right. Go on the Twitters if you haven't already. I mean, if you do have Twitter, if you feel like it. At HuxPlays is a good place to contact me with pictures and conversation and stuff. Go on there or maybe in the YouTube areas or whatever. Give me some inspiration for a tropical island. That's correct. That's right. You guessed correct. Tropical island is a thing. That is the plan here. And the reason is, I will tell you, I went back and forth a whole bunch in my brain. I went back and forth with like, what if I covered it in clay that was green? That would kind of look like grass. You know what I mean? But then I wouldn't be able to have actual like grass, you know, the grass you can grow with bone meal at all, but we can still do that on dirt and passive animals won't be able to spawn on dirt still. I hope, I think. Saying that, there's like all these animals and stuff up here, but I don't think that they spawned on the dirt. So I think that they were in the water and they climbed back up on the land. I'm pretty sure. I don't think they're spawning up here in the dirt, in case you're wondering about that. Oh, I'm pretty sure they can only spawn on grass. Anyway. Yeah, I went back and forth, like I said, but because, you know, I want to be able to have, like, actual bone meal grown grass and stuff to kind of fool your eyes, to make you not exactly see that it's dirt. It's also kind of realistic that it's dirt, because if this was, like, a tropical island, the salt water and stuff would be blocking out a lot of the grass from growing and everything in the first place. So there'd be little tufts and everything here every once in a while, so that'll be kind of realistic. Also, it'd just be a stupid amount of work to try and convert this all into clay, you know what I mean? It'd be really difficult. So, like I said, let me know if you got any ideas about how to make this into a super amazing tropical island. You know, obviously there's going to be like two little areas. There's going to be a pen here. There's going to be a pen over there. Two buildings. So any, you know, like Hawaiian grass hut style, like kind of maybe like a blend between like a real like modern restaurant versus like an old Hawaiian grass shack somewhere in between there. I don't know. Okay, let's fly around for a minute. I cleared a little bit of land over here out because it didn't really make sense to have a tiny little island over there, in case you're wondering. But yeah, check it out. We got a nice little canvas to work with. You know, I'm Bob Rossing it right now. We got a nice canvas. We're about to add some nice little happy chicken shacks. Cool. So let me know. Obviously, tweet me, do whatever you want, do things, give me some inspiration if you feel like it. I would love to hear from you guys, and hopefully we'll come up with something pretty cool here. So that's going to do it for me for today. Unfortunately, I'm running out of time. Just don't have it. And so sorry about that. I hope you guys can understand. But like I said, I'm going to get working here pretty soon, and we'll get some progress for you guys. So I'm pretty excited. Anyway, I love you guys to death. Thank you so much for freaking coming to hang out with me. Hope you turned your day around. If you're having a bad one, if you're having a good one, then you're gravy, baby. I'll see you in the next episode. Have a really good day. Bye-bye.